Three scientists have won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for their work developing one of the most widely used technologies in modern society, lithium-ion batteries. Rechargeable batteries have reshaped how we store energy and have reduced the world's reliance on fossil fuels.
It's hard to imagine a world without rechargeable batteries, your phone, your tablet, and now even your car. And it's all thanks to the genius of three scientists, today awarded the Nobel Prize for Chemistry.
For the development of lithium-ion batteries.
Akira Yoshino of Japan. Stanley Whittingham from the US. And John Goodenough, the oldest ever winner of a Nobel Prize at 97 years old. While the trio worked separately on the lithium-ion battery over decades, they each had a breakthrough that proved instrumental to our wireless society.
We have gained access to a technical revolution.
In the 1970s, Professor Whittingham harnessed lithium, the lightest metal, to make a functional battery, but it only generated 2 volts. By 1980, Professor Goodenough doubled that capacity, but it was still too unstable for commercial use. That's where Professor Yoshino came in. He eliminated pure lithium, using part of the metal instead, creating the first commercially viable, rechargeable lithium-ion battery. It's now a booming industry, not only enabling portable energy, but clean transport and even grid-scale storage of renewable energy, offering promise for Australia, the biggest producer of lithium in the world.
We as a nation ride this wave that's global now towards greater penetration of renewables, electric vehicles, and make sure we've got a really great seat at the table.
But the work is not finished.
Our goal is to double the energy density and cut the price in half. So you can all have electric vehicles, you can all use sun and wind and clean up the environment for everybody.
Looking forward to a cleaner, more sustainable future.
We need electric cars. We need to find a way to emancipate ourselves from our dependence upon the burning of fossil fuels.
The trio will meet in December to receive their prize. Amelia Dunn, SBS World News.